Hello everyone, this is Kiran Bhakotra. Welcome to in our next lecture, the fiber yielding plant. In our previous lecture, we discussed about the fiber yielding plant of cotton. So, in our next lecture, we discuss about the fiber yielding plant jute. Jute is also known as the golden fiber plant. It grows well on the alluvial soil and require the high temperature, heavy rainfall and humid climate. It means the most of the jute they grow in this the rich air fertile soil, then the temperature is a high, rainfall is a heavy and the climate are humid condition. So the all things are required for the jute plant grow. Jute is the plant of the genus Corchorus of a Tiliaceae family. They are belong to the genus is a Corchorus and the family is a Tiliaceae family. The principal two botanical species of the jute is a follow. It means the two species they are most oftenly cultivated in. They are the Corchorus capsularis. The common name is the white jute and the Corchorus olitoris. They are known as the dark jute or tosa. So there are two species are important. They are the origin and distribution. It means the primary center of this origin is the Corchorus olitoris. It is the Africa and the secondary state in the India and Indo-Burma. It means the Corchorus olitoris. It is mostly found in the first of all Africa region. And then they are found in the India or Indo-Burma region. And the second one is the Corchorus capsularis. They are the originate in the Indo-Burma region. And at this one time, it was the monopoly crop in the India which produced the 99% of the world production. It means they are the produce the 99% production of this world in our India. India and Bangladesh are the major producer these days, followed by the China, Myanmar, Nepal or Brazil. Out of China, Myanmar, Nepal and Brazil, the India and Bangladesh, they are the major producing of the jute plant. The Bangladesh is the largest exporter of the raw jute, while India leads to export of manufactured jute production. It means the jute plant are produced in the largest amount in Bangladesh, but further they are use of the raw material and manufacture a various product they in this our India. In India, the major jute growing state are the West Bengal, Assam, Bihar and Orissa. So in four regions, the most oftenly grow the jute plant in our India. The some botanical description of this jute plant is a they are jo plant is an annual herb plant. They generally shrubby plant and the height is a 2 to 3 meters tall. Then the stem is a very long and erect stranded structure. They are colorless variously from the green to dark red and branched stem. The root is a branch and taproot. The leaves are a simple and petiolate. The flower is a small and yellow in color and then generally capsule type of fruit. In this Corchorus capsularis, the pod are a round shape. And in this capsule, a Corchorus olitoris, the capsule are elongated in shape. So the both of this cultivated species are the woody branched annual having a simple ovate and serrate marginal leaves. The flowers are generally inflorescence is a solitary or arranged in a few flower cymose. In some species they are the solitary arrangement and some are they in the cymose. The Corchorus capsularis has a glabrous leaves. It means the smooth leaves. They containing a bitter glycoside or a corcorin chemicals. Small yellow flowers give rise to small and more or the less globular with the wrinkled capsule flattened at the top and enclosing the brown seed. They are the description of the flowers and fruit. And the most oftenly the fruit are a pod-like structure. And in this, the brown seeds are present. Then Corchorus olitoris is a much taller species, lives with the shining upper, the rough undersurface and with the no bitter taste. It means in this species the leaves are generally taller in size, the leaves are shining and they have a no bitter taste. Their yellowish color flower and the flower of olitoris, they comparison to large than the capsularis. The fruit is a long cylindrical capsule and the beak-like structure elongated, and the seed are small and green to gray or black in color. So this is the morphology of these two species. Then we discuss about the generally where plus is suitable for the jute. The jute is a rainy season crop. They are most often grow in the monsoon season. There is a no need for irrigation because they are grow in a rainy season, so they are the not requirement the water. If moisture is not sufficient in of the field after sowing the seed or before sowing the seed, the irrigation is given for proper germination. When the plant are grown in season but the moisture and water are not required to, then the water, it means the irrigation, it is compulsory benefit for the proper germination. Later on this crop, the irrigation when the plant are 10 to 12 cm tall and 3 to 4 leaves are formed. Okay, after the irrigation process is when the required, the when the plants is grow generally 10 to 12 cm grow and 3 to 4 are formed after the probably of this irrigation. Then the production and processing of the fiber ending plant. The jute is a rainy season crop shown from the March to May according to rainfall and the types of land. It means that generally the jute are shown from the field to March to May according to rainfall and the which type of the land are provided. Then the jute required a warm and humid climate with the temperature between the 24°C to 37°C. They have a rainfall season in most of the grow, so they are the humid climate are occurrence and the temperature is the between 24 to 37°C. The soil of the good deep containing salt from the annual floods is the best for the jute. It means the soil is a very good, it means the alluvial soil are beneficial for the, and they have a salt are present in the annual flood. It means the overflowing of the large amount of water, it is the best for the jute plant because the plant is a all over deep in this water. The stalk diameter of plant is generally 3 by 4 inches. Then the various stage of the producing and processing of the jute plant. The first of all, the in which time the jute are cultivation, then the harvesting, ratting, stripping, washing after drying, and the baling and packing, and the storage of jute material. So we first discuss on the cultivation process. So in this cultivation process, the sowing of the jute is in the March or April and they continues till the early June. They have a required for the phosphorus, potash and nitrogen fertilizers are used for this crop. So there are two fertilizer, the phosphorus, potash and the nitrogen used for this fertilizer. Then the harvesting process. The jute is the harvested in any time between the 120 days to 150 days and the flower have been shed. Early harvesting gives the good healthy fibers. The harvested plant are left in the field for the 3 days and for the leaves of this side, it means the means leaves got the dried up. It means ke jab bhi cultivation ke baad harvesting ke process hoti hai to wo 120 to 150 days ke between mein harvesting process hoti hai aur jab bhi flower ka formation ho jata hai uske baad, and the harvest plant they are the left into field after the 3 days, and when in this harvested plant the leaves are the dried up and the only stem are remaining. So after harvesting, the ratting process. In this ratting process, the fibers are loosened. This is a process which fiberglass loosened due to the decomposition of the hard cell walls by the action of bacteria, and the bundle are stripped in water at least 16 cm to 19 cm deep. After the process of the harvesting, they are the 3 to 4 days they are left in this field, but after this harvesting, the stem of the fibers, they are placed in this the strip hotel is mean the slope like area in this the water at least the 16 cm to 19 cm deep. In this the stem are decomposes. So when the decomposition of this stem, then the bacteria are hard shell, the decomposes and the fiber are loosened. There is a, you can see this in picture, the most oftenly the plant are growing in the water rainy season, the water are required. There is a stem of this jute plant, they are used in this jute. So they are the harvesting process of jute and they are the rotting of the jute. Okay, the bundle of the jute, they are placed in this watery condition. And the fiber decomposes of the fiber by the bacterial decomposition. There are the some process of this whole in this the rotting and after all over step. Okay, the bundle of the stamen are taken to the stagnant pool or ditch end and the lead fault in the water around the side by side so as to make a regular platform. It means that after the harvesting and rotting of this, the bundle of the stem, they are taken in a standard pool. It means they are a stable pool, they are or a narrow hole in the round. In this the water are required, so they are arranged in a side by side in this area. And the another layer of bundle is placed on the top right angle to the first. The surface of the bundle is covered with the weed or the other refuse and the heavily loaded with the stone and logs that keep them submerged. It means the whole bundles, they are submerged into water. This process is known as the rotting. They takes place is to 10 to 30 days in time. It means the rotting process is done about the 1 month, yani ki 20 to 30 days. We already discussed in previous slide. What is the rotting process? It is the consider completely when the bark can be easily peeled off. Okay, this rotting process, they completely the bark are removal. And for the stripping the plants of their bark. So the next our step is a stripping, the removing of the covering of this bark region. The worker stand in the waist deep water. Okay, generally the worker are standing in this deep water. So first of all, the roots or worst end, the stamen are beaten with a wooden melt and loosens the fiber. Then the free ends of the loosened fiber are the wrapped tightly round and the finger, the stem are backward and forward in water. So there are the separating of these fiber, the both backward and forward side. The stripping fiber are lashed on the surface of the water to remove the adhering beads of the paridens and peat and wash in the clean water and the wrung out. It means the when the fiber are stripped on the surface, so they are the peat portion are also removing of this fiber. And the next, the fibers are washed into clean water. They are the then strapped out in the sun or bamboo ranks on the 2 or 3 days, they rolled into bundle. Okay, after this stripping process, the bundles of they are the spread on the either they are the spread on the bamboo ring. They the lighting process, yani ki sun process, and they are the rest between the 2-3 days and after the roll into bundle. And the average yield of the fiber is about the 6% of the stem, the fresh weight. So after the rotting process, there is a stripping process. In this, the fiber are extraction. The stripping is the process of the removing of the fiber from the stalk after the completion of rotting. It means in this stripping process, the after the completion of the rotting, the removal of this fiber and the fiber are removed by the stalk. The one of the following method, it is the single plant are taken, the fiber are taken off, then the handful of the stalk backing into free motion in water. It means the single plants, single stem, they are used for the fiber are separated and they are the possessed in the motion of this water. Then our next step is a washing process. The extracted fiber are washed in a clean water and the dark color of the fiber can be removed by the dipping them in a tamarind water for the 15 to 20 meter and again washed in a clean water. It means after the completion of this process, the exterior of the fiber are washed in the clean water, and when the dark color of the fibers, they are removed in this dipping water, and they are the tremarid water. It means they are the water, they are the in this the content of the acidic water, they are 4 to 15 to 20 meters and again the washed in a clean water. Then the drying process in this, the fibers are hung on the bibles railing for the sun drying for 2 to 3 days. The fibers, they are the spread on this bamboo railing for the opposite of this sun direction for the 2 to 3 days. And after the drying, the fiber are ready to be sold in this market. You can see this in picture, how the horse, the jute plants are in a water the horsing, and after horsing the bamboos in this, they are the hung and the drying process. And after the drying, they are the spinning into rolling structure, and after the raw jute fiber are ready to sold in market. There is some properties of this jute plant. The jute fiber, they have a range from generally 1 to 8 to 3 meter in a length, and they are generally pale yellow to yellowish white in color. In the process is a silk like glass. Then the fiber tend to deterioration when the exposed over damp slabs. Normally they have the steep, brittle and coarse with the low stretchability and the elasticity. During this process, the end of some individual fiber in the bundle, they are the loosening and resulting where the amount of the hardness which prevent the slipping. The individual fiber vary from 2 to 5 micrometer in length, millimeter in length, and they are the polygonal in the cross section, have a smooth surface. They are the wide in luminaire present, and they take off the dry while the wet, but the jute is difficult to bleach. The utilization of jute in this, the jute is the world's most important bagging and wrapping textile. It means the jute are most often used in a bagging, it means the cloth is, and the wrapping, it means the covering textile use. About 75% of the jute production, they are annually used in the manufacture of the sacks and bags. Bags and the sacks means the most of the pulses are storage in this bag. They are the making of the jute material. It is also used in the manufacture of the rugs, blanket, carpet, tarpaulins, cloth bagging, carpets, twines, ropes, curtains, clothings, and etc. And also the leaves and the young shoots. They are the important source of the vegetable food. They are also used in the preserve of the vegetable food in this the area of the Egypt, Sudan, and Greece. And the jute boards are used in the manufacture of the paper and the paper board. Then another uses of the jute is they are the chiefly for the rough weaving. The thick cloth they made from the jute fiber is used from the making of gunny bags, means the taking a gun in this bag. They are the made up of in this jute material. The another type of the fine cloth prepared from the jute fiber, they are used to cloth to slip on. The another type of the coarse cloth is the largely used for the making the sails of the country boats. It means they are useful on the boats and also useful for the making of ships and the bags of the large seed or food. They are the storage. The jute is extensively used in the manufacture of the carpet and also other the mixed with the silk and used for the silk fibers. The fiber is also used the making the twines and ropes process. The short fiber and pieces from the lower ends, the stock continuous jute boots, which are used in the some extent maker promoting. It means the large fiber, they are used in this clothes and other uses, but the short fibers, they are used in the paper making industry. So in this lecture we discuss about the fiber ending plant of the jute, when the conditions are favorable, when the place or the origin and distribution, then the two species, the capsularis and olentosis, they are the useful in the, they are most often grow in the Indo-Burma region and the Bangladesh. Then, the what is the plant morphology, and after the cultivation, they are the cultivation, harvesting, ratting, watering, dipping, drying, the all the process, they are the made up of this jute. So in this lecture, we completed the life cycle of jute. So in this next lecture, we discuss about the next fiber yielding plants. Thank you.